I think if there is a comment on it. I think it's interesting, you know, to, you know, I would like to come back to Sveli and to body vibe. Still, you know, there was a discussion also on the term it was not, yeah, so Sveli had a dilemma whether to use the term body knowing, and then we had a discussion and Lizette actually proposed body wise, which is after Oitsika, I think.
But isn't it an adjective body wise?
No,
not body,
it's a concept.
You are body wise.
No, body wise, but I'm not certain.
Oh, it's a
we could use it because she doesn't really know what is body wise. Actually, what she presented has to do with body wise, because she's talking about a knowledge concept.
But I don't feel confident to have here in this glossary, the term body wise used because it belongs to a structure and to someone who already thought about it.
So it's very difficult to do it here with the term in Spanish and in French, which was saber el cuerpo. And we just have to find another.
It was the question of translation.
Savoir is knowledge. Savoir is knowledge. But she says that she doesn't want the word knowledge. Mm-hmm. Then I don't know. Savoir is not knowledge.
She's a knowing. Well, in Spanish you have this distinction between saber and conocimiento, which will be similar to knowledge and wisdom. That's why I think that wisdom is more Dutch.
But maybe we should just use the French.
Just me for documentation reasons. I know that it's really hard to follow, yeah, but the debate is really loud. Could you please pass the mic around? Excuse me.
Well, I mean, just because the body wisdom, not as a reuse of the Tika term, but as a translation of saber el cuerpo, which was the term that Sueli was proposing.
Yeah, I think it's
fine. But I think we shouldn't decide in her name. So it's something that we need to inform her about the discussion, and then she decides in her turn how she names it. I think it's coming back to Russia's term. I remember, you know, it's really a specific experience when you are in the street in uprising situation with your body. I experienced it in Ukraine years ago. I think it is something. It is a different knowledge. It's difficult to describe. So maybe that's why I related it to Sveli's presentation. It's not absolutely the same thing, but it is an experience which maybe is close to
affects the way that.
I'm just wondering a little bit about the timing of this, and it's really a condition not here, and we also don't have anyone else from this region here today. But well, she's from Lebanon, isn't she?
Yeah.
So I'm just wondering about why she's proposing it now, and I would, my interpretation, which is not here, so it can only be an interpretation, is that it's almost like an act of defiance to propose this now, because of course this moment is kind of long past, isn't it? I mean, if you see what's happening now in Syria, talking about the dancing in Syria, I mean, it doesn't really cover what's happening right now, I suppose. So mentioning it now must have some meaning. And I think that the question of timing when you propose something is also important for our discussion.
But I don't know, did all of us think of our notions as something like really topical happening now? Because I think
notions. Yeah, it's
a question that I have to this topic, to this term.
difference now, okay?
Yeah, yeah, I didn't think of thinking about it, that it has to be like referring to the contemporary.
No, I also don't think all the terms need to do that. It's just a question to this term, because I think for me it must have some meaning.
No, I think in this case I think it's a tiny term. I think that has to do with the contemporary. It's true that if you think of it dancing, if you compare it to what's going on in Syria and other places, but what it has in common is that the body is central. It can be the body that is dancing or the body that is suffering. Mm-hmm. But I have the impression that it's still very much an important issue. That the body is somehow the uprising, the body is the agent of the uprising, is the agent of the dancing, but also of the suffering body, of the dismembered body, or the beheaded body, or the raped body. So I think it's a very important issue, even if not necessarily not only related to dancing. And I wanted to point out that the idea of the uncertainty or the difficulty to define a political subjectivity based on that body, because that would be also a danger to identify the new political subject with the body. The presence of the body is the potence, is the possibility of a new political subject. Is the kind of, let's say, saying, okay, the representations that were valid till now, they are not valid, and that's why we have to come forth and with our bodies. But there's previous somehow to a determination. So it's somehow it's what breaks the political subjectivity that is, and obviously it's instituted in this.
It would be interesting to just think about it, about Sikas, the way it's the dancing in the body is used with him. Maybe you can make this link or say something about it.
Yes, but I can't connect it with the riots or exactly. Well, it's much more about performing.
But it's about politics of the bodies. Yeah, I think.
What is in common here? The self-awareness that starts with the body. I'm talking from my own experience being in the street.
Yeah.
During the riots here, and it was not only my experience, but in a certain moment I really felt as a collective experience that people became very self-confident in a way, all for a short time, but there was this self-awareness which I think starts with the body sometimes.
Yes. I'm just trying to go back to all the pieces that he connected with body-wise, and at that time they were much. They had to do with suprasensorial experiences. And I'm trying to remember, but it will be anachronical, I think, in his case. I don't know. I have to think it better.
Should we go to the other?
Just a very short comment, because I think it would be interesting to complement this insistence that Rashi puts on the physical experience with the image of that physical experience, because the image of the Arab Spring was key to the spread of the insurrectional practice in Spain, in New York, and in other places. And this opened a completely new political moment. So, when I was reading her text, I had some doubts of this insistence of the physical experience without a connection to the image of that experience as a way of communicating the image, the representation of the physical experience, and how this created a kind of will to spread this kind of practice of occupying the public space.
Yeah.
it's something I was trying to get at with my terms of determination, but perhaps all the successful activities in Russia, when she talks about the sort of formation of the collective subject, sort of in becoming, and in that in becoming, some sort of agency is being taken. That's something that I was trying to hint at with self-determination. So for me, there was an in there. Shall I read self-representation?
Yes, yeah.
So self-representation. Under the referential field subjectivization, Song proposes to discuss the term self-representation. The contemporary society is outspoken with personal statements of the self. Be it a constructed identity or the genuine bearer of singular ideas, oneself is rendered explicit by ordinary daily tools, including the typical social media channels. In the digital world of followers, we hold the power of creating liabilities between the statements and the actions of the self. This power has the capability of turning every one of us into representatives of our presented selves. It is much easier to follow the popular, the mediatic, and provide criticism as it is exercised in media itself. However, the liabilities of being followed are even much more stronger among a circle of friends. Song suggests to discuss self-representation by examples of the people we befriend and follow, artists and collectives who work with different tools of representation. The discussion will include works and projects by a young architecture collective, Architecture for All, Syrian America artist, Syrian Armenian artist, Aria Sakisan, artist, network analyst, Burak Arikan, and the exhibition Disobedience Archive, The Park, by Marco Scottini and Andres Brinkwitz, which was shown in spring 2014 at Sol. Selected works and projects will discuss how the ideas of the self are represented in various public manifestations. The exhibition will demonstrate an example of resistance from the self towards the follower, when the self is demanded to package itself into a representation.